Diabetes affects over 25 million people in the United States. That's according to the American Diabetes Association. If you're a diabetic, you may have trouble losing weight. We spoke with Dr. Bryan Stone at Desert Regional Medical Center about why it's so difficult to lose weight when taking medications for diabetes.
Diabetes is far more complicated than just sugars and weight gain. And what we're finding is that as we come out with more and more medications, there's dozens of them now, we're dealing with the side effects of the medications as well. Most of the medications have a side effect of weight gain. And we have to remember that diabetes is not really just a sugar disease. It's about a hormone imbalance. And that imbalance typically involves too much insulin because of insulin resistance. Now, insulin is also a growth hormone. So that causes weight gain. It makes you grow. And as we use medications that enhance the effect of insulin, what are we getting? We're getting additional weight gain. Now, the metabolic syndrome, which is what's popular in the news at this time, basically says that people are gaining weight, this imbalance is occurring more, and we're getting more and more people with diabetes, and we're getting them very young. And so they're all going on these medications. So they gain weight, the diabetes gets worse, they go on the medication to control the sugars, and what happens is they start gaining more weight and become worse. It's not that the medicine doesn't work, it's that we have to control the side effects of the medication. We have to be very careful about what we're using and balance these things. Now, metformin, which is the number one recommended in my book, does not cause weight gain. In fact, it causes a little bit of weight loss, so it's one of my preferred medications for that reason. But most of the other medications, whether it's insulin or the sulfonylurea drugs, which are very commonly used, have that side effect. So how do we counteract that? Well, we have to remember diabetes is not just about sugars. We need to cause that hormone imbalance to shift back, and the closest thing we could do is to exercise. When we exercise, we start having weight loss, we start shifting that hormone imbalance back so that the body becomes more sensitive to insulin. Without exercise, it's very, very difficult to fully control your diabetes. Now, a lot of patients come and say, well, but my sugars are good. I've been taking this medicine, my sugars are good, I feel good. I don't really want to exercise, is basically what they're saying. And a lot of patients tell us that without verbalizing that. And I tell them, look, I had a patient when I was in training where this gentleman came in, he started having breakdown of his toes, and he ended up getting his part of his foot removed. And we said, well, why is this happening to this patient? Let's look around. And we fully investigated him, looked for sugar tests, artery disease, all sorts of things. This gentleman was only about 50. We could not find diabetes anywhere. So being a kidney guy, we biopsied his kidneys. Classic diabetic damage throughout the kidney. What's the learning point? The learning point is it's not just about sugars. This guy did not have any high sugars. In fact, he defeated our normal testing. We could not even find the high sugars, and yet he had diabetic disease. The hormone imbalance is the key. That's not to say none of the medicines work. I just want to reiterate that it's important to know that. The medicines do work, but you have to have you have to have multiple methods of going after diabetes. One pill is not the cure.